So we plot the horizontal line for the shear force diagram, and we plot all those salient points A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. On y-axis, we have shear force, and on x-axis, we have the length of beam. Positive shear force will be above the horizontal line, and negative shear force will be below this horizontal line. Now shear force towards right of A is 5 kN. So by taking proper scale, let us plot 5 kN shear force at point A. Next, shear force towards left of B is 5 kN. So at point B, let us plot 5 kN shear force, and let us connect these two points by a horizontal line, which means that shear force remains constant between point A and B. Shear force towards right of B is minus 15 kN. So again at point B, let us plot minus 15 kN shear force, and let us connect it with the vertical line. Next, shear force towards left of C is minus 15 kN. So again at point C, a minus 15 kN shear force. And let us connect it with point B by a horizontal line, denoting that shear force remains constant between point B and C. Now shear force towards right of C is minus 5 kN. So we plot minus 5 kN shear force at point C, and let us connect this by a vertical line. Now shear force towards left of E is minus 5 kN. So at point E, we have minus 5 kN shear force, and let us connect it with point C by a horizontal line, denoting that shear force is constant between point C and E. And shear force towards left of F is minus 25 kN. Now we see between point E and F, we have uniformly distributed load. So variation of shear force between point E and F will be linear. So let us connect with the inclined straight line. Now shear force towards right of F is 35 kN. So let us also plot a 35 kN shear force using proper scale, and let us connect it by means of vertical line. Now shear force towards left of G is plus 25 kN. So at point G, let us plot plus 25 kN shear force. Now again we see between point F and G, there is a uniformly distributed load. So variation of shear force between F and G will be linear. So let us connect it with a inclined straight line. And finally, to the zero line. So we see shear force is positive between A and B and F and G, whereas it is negative between point B and F. At point B, shear force changes from positive value to negative value. So our positive bending moment will be maximum at point B, whereas at point F, our shear force changes from negative value to positive value. So our negative bending moment will be maximum at point F. So with this, our shear force diagram is complete. Let us now move towards bending moment calculation.